While in Egypt, a dying pharaoh's tomb gets all bent out of shape. And in Spain, a castle stands at risk of attack unless a nobleman makes the ultimate sacrifice. Join me on a journey to these and other fabled places where blood was shed, but the dead are not forgotten. I'm Josh Gates. I've traveled millions of miles and explored over 100 countries.
The whole wall is literally disintegrating.
It's collapsing!
And my favorite destinations have epic tales to tell. These are the stories and the secrets of those legendary locations. Sitting just southwest of the bustling Egyptian capital of Cairo is the granddaddy of historical places and one of the most recognizable landscapes in the world. Built over 4,500 years ago, these pyramids are the quintessential symbols of ancient engineering. But success is often built on failure, and a desolate burial ground to the south, called Dahshur, is where the Egyptians went wrong before they got it right. Here, you'll find the flawed prototype that made the pyramids of Giza possible. The Egyptians called it the Southern Shining Pyramid, but its odd shape has inspired a less flattering nickname: the Bent Pyramid. When it was erected, the Bent Pyramid was the world's tallest structure, as high as a 34-story building, and nearly 40 feet taller than the Statue of Liberty stands today. The pyramid's sides rise at a steep angle, but about halfway up, they abruptly taper off at a shallower slant. Why the Bent Pyramid is bent ranks as one of history's oldest mysteries. The only clues we have come from the story of its construction as the tomb for one of Egypt's earliest pharaohs. It's around 2600 BCE. Egypt's ruler, Sneferu, dreams of being laid to rest in the grandest monument the world has ever seen. He's looking for something a little slicker than the first pyramid that was completed decades earlier. The Step Pyramid of Djoser was constructed kind of like a layer cake, made of platforms receding in size from the ground up. Ever the visionary, Sneferu wants a smooth-sided pyramid. Though nothing like this has ever been successfully completed, construction seems to proceed without a hitch. At first, anyway. But around the midway point, Sneferu's master plan gets, well, bent out of shape. One theory for the change in angle is that Sneferu already had one foot in the grave, and if his builders follow the original design, they won't finish the pyramid in time for his burial. But if they continue construction at a shallower angle, they'll need less stone and less time. But the real reason that construction turned to crisis is because the pharaoh's architects realized the angle of the pyramid's sides, 54 degrees, is too steep. And it looks like it might collapse. The solution is to change course, altering the angle to a gentler slope of 43 degrees. The consensus among experts is clear. The second theory is right, supported by the existence of this other pyramid just half a mile away. This is the Red Pyramid, also commissioned by King Sneferu and built soon after the Bent Pyramid. It's where he was actually entombed, which means he couldn't have been at death's door if they had time to build it. The angle of the Red Pyramid sides is 43 degrees, the same angle as the top level of the Bent Pyramid. So it looks like the Egyptians learned from their mistake and built this one at the gentler angle from the get-go. What the ancient Egyptians came to discover was something called the angle of repose. It's like sand in an hourglass. When material is poured on a horizontal plane, a conical pile will form at an angle between 0 and 90 degrees without slumping. For dry sand, it's 34 degrees. But for the limestone the Egyptians were using, it was 43 degrees. Hence, it's more naturally stable. But the Bent Pyramid's problems extend beyond its funky shape. By the 19th century, not only have the elements taken their toll, but treasure-hunting adventurers are desecrating Egypt's ancient past. Grave robbers plunder burial sites for profit, and the mummies they find are sold to the highest bidders. Some of the mummies even get ground up to make paint or medicines. But in the late 19th century, British archaeologist William Flinders Petrie arrives on the scene and changes everything. He leads a movement to responsibly study the Bent Pyramid and to preserve it for posterity. Only one potentially deadly obstacle stands in his way. It turns out the locals don't care for foreigners poking around the pharaoh's tombs. He knows many archaeologists studying the pyramids have been beaten or even killed by Egyptians who thought they were grave robbers. And he doesn't want to join that club. Knowing that Egyptian custom dictates not to approach any person considered to be insane, it is said that Petrie surveys while decked out in a ballerina tutu. There are also some accounts of Petrie working completely naked just so people would leave him alone, which is definitely something I'm gonna start trying. All this might sound a little extreme, but it sure was effective. And it tells us a lot about Petrie. He took the time to study Egyptian customs and used that knowledge to his advantage. You gotta respect that. Even though Petrie's genius is unconventional, his work is groundbreaking. He's the first archaeologist to make accurate measurements of the pyramids, beginning the systematic investigations at Dahshur and Giza that continue to this day. He spent over 60 years in Egypt and in the Middle East, ultimately becoming known as the father of modern archaeology. In a strange side note, when Petrie died in Jerusalem in 1942 at age 89, his final request was to have his head preserved in formaldehyde so his brain could be saved for posterity. But when it was shipped to London, they lost it. Don't worry, it eventually turned up. As for the Bent Pyramid, it sees a lot less visitors and tchotchke vendors than its fancier, straighter counterparts in Giza. But they owe all their glory to the one that came first.